Black Teacher is a 1976 memoir by the Guyanese author and educator Beryl Gilroy. Born in 1924 in what was then British Guiana, Gilroy came to Britain in 1951 as part of the Windrush generation. She was already an experienced teacher when she arrived, and she was excited, she tells us, by the new educational techniques being pioneered in Britain. She quickly gained a diploma in child development from the University of London. Black Teacher is partly a book about racism. All went well, she says, until it was time to take off my student's scarf and try to be a teacher. The fact was that as a Guyanese, I simply could not get a teaching post. She experiences racism virtually everywhere she goes, and it's nearly always overt and vicious. But this is also a book about education and about the power of goodness. Gilroy had an unshakable faith in children generally, which she transmits to the reader. Right at the end of the book, she reveals in passing that she kept a diary, and it's perhaps from this that she reconstructed the teachers and the pupils with whom she interacted. She's a skilled storyteller, and her pen portraits are never less than fully convincing. There's an awful lot in here that's shocking. Most people now know how appalling British racism could be in the post-war period, but Black Teacher still has the power to shock. In chapter 5, after Gilroy finally gets a teaching post in a Roman Catholic school, teaching 42 7-year-olds, she's taken to meet her class. Unfortunately, no one's told them she's black. So when I opened the squeaking door, she tells us, and the class came face to face with me, there was a gasp of terror, then a sudden silence. A little girl broke it with a whimper. Some of the children visibly shook, and as I walked across the room, the whole lot, apart from two boys, dived under the tables. One of the boys proudly tells her he isn't afraid. How does she react? Well, this is partly what makes the book so inspiring, the way she always finds hope, even in the least promising of situations, even where most other people would despair. She goes to the blackboard, wipes it noisily, and begins to improvise a story about a pond. Gradually, the children emerge and tentatively add to or comment on the story. It's just one of many such moving scenes. There's a lot of humour. In chapter 12, Gilroy's class embarks on an impromptu discussion of the controversial politician Enoch Powell. According to one of the children, Mr. Plowell goes to his church and plays his banjo there. There's an emphasis on mutual understanding throughout. Late on in the book, when a Republican-minded parent walks out of a school function in response to the national anthem, Gilroy is furious. "I don't care how much you hate the Queen, and I don't care what you stand for," she tells him. "All I care about is the example of good manners, self-control, and tolerance that you set here in this school." Black Teacher is an outstanding book. Given the sheer volume and intensity of the racism to which the author was exposed all the way through, even after she became a head teacher, it ought to be dispiriting, but it isn't. It's exceptionally uplifting. Here's a highly educated woman who's received a lifetime of verbal abuse from people who are rarely fit to hold a candle to her, and she not only retained her faith in human nature, but continually took practical steps to improve the world. In our 2020 foreword to the book, Bernardine Evaristo wrote, "Anyone who thinks that Britain hasn't moved forward in terms of racism and equality should read this book." I'd agree, but I'd add that the bar was so low in Gilroy's day that things could have improved substantially and still be bad today. In any case, there aren't many autobiographies from which the author emerges as a hero. That's a word that's often used lightly nowadays, but in this case, it more than fits the bill.